Most people are really excited about this stage of making their portfolio, and indeed, it's time to work on the visual identity of your portfolio. I'll introduce here the main visual elements that you need to define, and although those elements need to reflect you and your identity, I will also cover the good practices of making your portfolio easy to navigate for your visitors. Fonts and typography scale are usually made of the following: a heading for your page titles, a subheadings for your section titles, a lead text for bigger text sizes like in hero areas, your intros or quotes, a body text to use for most of your content, a caption text to use as caption for your images or embedded elements. And I'd like to mention that it's usually okay to choose one font that is different for your headings compared to your body text. But I would recommend using a standard font for your body text. These fonts are standard for a reason. They are easy to read, and you actually don't want to strain the eyes of your reader, especially if they've been looking at portfolios all day long. Colors are used for the following elements: text color, usually black or dark gray. Don't go too light, as it may make your text difficult to read and not accessible. The reverse applies if you want a portfolio in dark theme. A dominant color for your main call to actions, like buttons and links. A supporting color for your secondary actions, usually less vibrant and less saturated dominant color. An accent color. If you're including illustrations of pictures, you can be intentional and choose an accent color and use touches of it throughout your portfolio. Some background colors, usually a combination of white and grays, to organize your content section. Again, if you're doing a dark theme here, there'll be a combination of black and dark grays. And unless you're an expert in visual design, don't go crazy with colors. Use online palette editors to help you choose and calibrate your colors. A grid system. If you're designing your portfolio for the web, you will also need to define your grid system, similar to when you do it for your digital projects. Things to consider are, for example, what's your maximum width? Do you want to center your content on one main column, or use layouts and organize content into two or three columns? You can also play with grid offsets to structure your content, as long as it's consistent across your portfolio. Responsiveness. Again here, for the web, you need to care about how your content is displayed on various screen sizes, usually desktop, tablet, and mobile. You can rely here on the web builder tools that you choose to use and their behaviors. Or if you have code knowledge, you can do it with media queries and flexboxes. Accessibility. Your website must be accessible. If your case studies showcase your work on accessibility but your portfolio is not, well, it may constitute a red flag for hiring managers. And finally, a logo. A well-crafted logo can be a big plus for your portfolio's visual identity. However, it is not mandatory at all. If you don't have a strong background in visual design, I would even recommend not to have any logo at all, as it can be badly designed and play against you. If you are a UX designer with no visual background at all, or maybe a UX researcher with no visual background, then I would actually recommend you to use templates online. Choose one that you can customize, again using palette editors to make sure that your colors are consistent, but you can play around with that and also, as usual, get feedback on your work and iterate from there.